Good evening. Thanks so much for being with us tonight. It's been nearly 2 years since six-year-old Sierra Newbold was kidnapped from her bedroom and then found in a canal near her home.
Well, tonight her parents are talking about their healing process and how the community has not forgotten them. In fact, quite the opposite.
Heidi Hatch live now in West Jordan with our story. Heidi?
Well, Sean and Mark, the Newbold family has truly been embraced over the last couple of years by their neighborhood and by the full West Jordan community. We're here at West Jordan Elementary tonight because the community is throwing them a huge party on Saturday. There'll be a yard sale, bake sales, fun for the whole family, and the idea is to raise money to make sure this family feels at home in their own home. The Newbolds are healing, but their home is also an open wound. The sliding glass door where the perpetrator entered, a constant reminder of what was lost.
Just brings more kind of feelings of guilt because I didn't have it locked and I should have, and it'll be nice to have that gone.
The family has slowly made a few small changes, starting with a new table.
We had a rectangle table and I couldn't fake myself out. There was always an empty seat, and that was hard.
Neighbors want to help and are pulling together to drastically change their home.
This is Sierra's only home. And so that makes it a little bit harder to leave it because this is her home.
Staying, however, is not always easy. Sierra's little sister, Taylor, who shared her room, can no longer sleep alone.
She'll fall asleep in her bed.
And when her parents move her back to her room,
she just sneaks in and, you know, we realize when we wake up in the morning, she's in bed.
And even still, moving is not an option.
The love and support that we've received from this neighborhood and this community, there's no way I'd want to. There's one bad seed out of so much love, one little act of hate and evil, and so much love and support.
Support that started on day one.
The first time that we pulled into the neighborhood, and there's just ribbons all up and down, and it's very touching.
I just broke down in the car and took your breath away, just knowing that everybody cared that much.
2 years later, purple ribbons still hang on the family's front porch, a reminder of wide-eyed Sierra.
Her smile, her hugs, and her laugh. She had a very contagious laugh, and the love that she had for her sister.
Because they were best friends.
And as the family moves forward,
I would just like to thank everybody for everything that they've done. I mean, almost 2 years, it's just been nonstop.
Organizers need a big turnout on Saturday to make sure they can do everything they'd like to for the home renovation for the Newbold family. If you want to take part, it is Saturday morning. It should be gorgeous out here. Starts at 8 a.m., goes all the way till 4 p.m. If you want to figure out how you can maybe donate or just come join in the fun, we go to KUTV.com. We have all the information posted right there. Mark and Shauna.
All right, Heidi, thank you very much.